Welcome to Disney Debunked, where we take Disney's most common myths and urban legends and find out what's fact and what's fiction.
On today's episode, we discover what's inside the Matterhorn's Peak and find out if Walt Disney himself is hiding inside the Haunted Mansion.
Disney myth number 487. One of the singing busts on the Haunted Mansion is actually Walt Disney. In the graveyard scene on the Haunted Mansion, there are a set of singing busts originally conceptualized and designed by Imagineer Mark Davis. You will notice that one of the busts on the far left bears a striking resemblance to Walt himself, leading people to believe that it's actually Walt Disney singing Grim Grinning Ghosts. The fact that this bust is broken also contributed to this myth because people began to view it as an homage to Walt Disney, who had died a few years before the attraction opened in 1969. This myth is false. The lead singer of the graveyard bust is actually Thurl Ravenscroft. While he does closely resemble Walt, Ravenscroft has his own notable history in the Disney parks and beyond. You'll remember him performing You're a Mean One, Mr. Grinch from How the Grinch Stole Christmas and as the original voice of Tony the Tiger. Ravenscroft also narrated the 1969 record, The Story and Song from the Haunted Mansion. His likeness was also replicated for the 2003 Haunted Mansion movie featuring Eddie Murphy.
Where's the key? Where's the key? Where's the beautiful key? Find the key, find the key. Oh, how happy you'll be.
While he lended his voice to multiple Disney television shows and movies, his other theme park contributions include Fritz the Parrot from the Enchanted Tiki Room, the voice of the first mate on the Mark Twain Riverboat, the American Bison Buff at the Country Bear Jamboree, and multiple singing pirates on Pirates of the Caribbean.
Oh, and the old sourpuss on the wall, the buffalo head.
Oh,
sing it, babe, come on, sing it, babe. And I've done, I'm the parrot in the Enchanted Tiki Room.
Let me hear the parrot.
Well, we're going to show you all a trick now. We're going to make you all disappear.
You got to love that.
I studied for Grand Opera, and I was going to be a Grand Opera singer. So that, you know, helped me develop my voice. And then I found out I could have a lot more fun and make more money doing animals and working for Disney and doing Tony and et cetera. So I never went into opera.
So while the singing bust is not actually Walt Disney, Thurl Ravenscroft definitely deserves our commemoration for being such a big part of Disney theme park history. Debunked.
Myth number 29, there's a secret basketball court hidden in the top of the Matterhorn. During the production of Third Man on the Mountain in 1958, Walt Disney fell in love with Switzerland scenery and sent a postcard of the mountain to Imagineers with the simple request to build this. The idea of a basketball court being tucked away in the Matterhorn's Peak originated from Anaheim City ordinances prohibiting structures of a certain height. The rumor that in order to build the mountain to its grandiose scale, Walt needed to incorporate a basketball court so the structure would be classified as a sports facility. This myth is both true and false. In a small space near the top of the peak, there is actually a basketball rim with a backboard and floor markings, but it's smaller than a regulation size half court. This has been verified by numerous backstage photos throughout Disney history and firsthand accounts by Matterhorn cast members. I'm here with Leslie, a Fantasyland Attractions cast member who used to be a Matterhorn, correct?
Yes.
So is there or is there not a basketball court in the top of Matterhorn?
There is, technically. It's not like full-scale nice floors. It's a wooden room with a basketball court or a basketball hoop on the wall.
Cool.
Have you played basketball there?
I have not. I've been up there because we all get to go up after we learn the attraction, and when we get signed off, we go up there, we sign the wall, and I didn't have enough time to actually shoot basketball, but I have been up there.
However, the rumor that the Matterhorn needed to be classified as a sports arena is false. Anaheim Sydney ordinances didn't prevent height restrictions on buildings until the 1970s, and the Matterhorn was completed in 1959. The space was originally used as a break room and preparation area for costume climbers who entertained park guests scaling the outside of the mountain. The basketball court came into fruition when these performers simply were looking for ways to pass the time when they were unable to climb the exterior.
Walt Disney thought what would be the strangest thing to put up there, and he talked to the people that were both the mountain climbers and ride operators, and what would you like to use that space for? Because it was a big empty space up above where the roller coaster ride runs around from about two-thirds on down, but that upper third, the pointed part, was empty. And so they put their heads together and they said, you know, we'd like to play basketball.
So while Disneyland's first e-ticket attraction has more than meets the eye, Walt Disney wasn't trying to pull a fast one on the city of Anaheim. Disney, debunked.
If you learned something new in this episode of Disney Debunked, give it a big thumbs up and let us know in the comments down below what myth you'd like us to debunk next episode.
Thanks so much for watching, and remember to click subscribe for more Disney videos every week. This has been Disney Debunked.